create dancing. I am a can of whoop ass ready to open. I really wish these niggas would stop fronting on me.
Niggas try to front, we move on them. Niggas think something sweet till we move on them. Yeah.
Welcome to Ripley's Auto. What's up, everybody? I know you look at the timer counter on the video and you saw 16 minutes and you're wondering, what is he going to talk about for 16 minutes? Check it out. If you don't have 16 minutes of time right now, just save this video to your watch later folder and come back to it when you get a chance, because you're going to love it. You know, sometimes I give y'all some more insight on me personally, maybe some things that happened to me in my life or whatever, and this is one of them. It's gonna be a couple of stories, so that's why I'm doing it on this longer video. Now, I know you're looking at the title and you're wondering what in the world I'm talking about when I say white people party hard. I'm an 80s baby. I was born in 1974, so during the 80s, used to have all these movies like Animal House, Revenge of the Nerds, PCU. It was all about college. And basically, my view of college was what we're in these movies. So when I graduated high school in 1992, the smartest decision I did was to go to college. Well, the dumbest idea I ever made was not to go to college. And what I mean by not go to college, that means go to class every day like I was supposed to. So basically, my first run of college didn't go well. But I did learn some things that I still, you know to this day. One of the things I learned in college was how to play pool. And the reason I learned how to play pool, because the dorm I stayed in had a game room. And the game room had video games, then it had like 8 pool tables. And with this little short girl that used to work there, I kind of was crushing on her. She was an upperclassman, I was a freshman. But yo, I always go down there and we have, you know, conversations and whatnot. And I play games. I learned how to play pool. Even when she was working, I wasn't there. She had my number, she'll call to see what I was doing and want me to come hang out with her down there or whatnot. So I learned how to play pool, just being down there conversating with her. You know, get the table, get the pool balls, and just shoot and shoot and shoot. Funny thing about playing pool is, if you don't have no sense of geometry, you can't play. And the crazy thing is, math is my worst subject. If it ain't multiplying, dividing, adding money, I just don't get it. Well, let me tell you about an interesting story with my pool skills. One night we go out to the club. We're deep. I'm like 15 deep. And then we get to the club, and of course there's more people I know. Now, as a freshman, I was real popular, so I knew a lot of people. So now we're in a club all together. We're probably like 50 deep. And this little club had this little pool table like you probably see in the bowling alleys where you put 50 cent in to play a game till all the balls are gone and like the rails are real tight. Pretty much a bowling alley pool table. So we back there playing pool or whatever. And I'm playing against one of my friends. This cocky dude walks back there to the back. He puts down $20 on the table. He said, I got $20 on the next game. Who wanted to match me? So I said, yo, I'll match you. I pull out 20, put it on the table. I win the game that I was playing. And so he racks the balls up or whatever, and me and him getting ready to play. And I had my boy Tony, aka Lope Dawg. I know y'all probably heard me mention him once or twice in a conversation. I had him the cue stick. Now my man looking at me puzzled. He said, hold on man, we got $40 on the game. I said, yeah we do. I said, but you said you got $20 on the next game. This is the next game. I'm tired. I'm going to let my man shoot. He said, no, that ain't what I'm talking about. Me and you supposed to play. I said, no, you didn't say you had the winner. You just said you had the next game. So now you got the next game. You shooting against my man. Because, see, he was kind of scoping me out. And I was kind of tipsy. So I was making, like, stupid mistakes or whatever with my shooting. But I know my boy Tone was sober. So I told the dude, I said, you know what? Whereby I let him shoot. My money down. Either way, if you win, you won't get the $40. I let him shoot. But I call his shots. But the guy that me talking about, he must be out your mind. I said, you can pick your 20 up and bounce. Or not. What you wanna do? And then he act like he wanted to board with me. And then that's when he realized everybody that was sitting around there, male and female that were watching the pool games, who with me. So then he'd be like, you know what? Fine. I'll do it. Let's go. Sure enough, got his $20. Put my $20 back in my pocket. Gave Tone the other $20. So as you see, one thing I learned in college was how to be a hustler. Another thing I learned in college was to have a great drinking tolerance. And that's when it goes to white people party hard. Before that whole pool incident ever happened, my orientation at ECU that summer is when I met Tone. I had a math placement class I had to take to see where I was going to place that math in the beginning of the semester. Before the test even happened, the instructor had everybody, you know, tell their name, where they was from, and whatnot. It was a guy in the class named Joe. He was from Maryland. I'm from D.C. So immediately we look at each other like, ah, let me holler at you after we get up out of here. So out of the class, we holler at each other. He's supposed to be on the track team. And that's what he's down there for a track scholarship. So he's like, yo, man, later on, some of the guys talking about going down to the club, hanging out with all the freshmen going and everything. Is everybody be at? So I said, all right. And so when I get around into his room, everybody on that side of the hall on the track team or some type of athlete or something. And then I run into my man Tone, because we at ECU, so the black population was a little slimmer than the white population. So I see my man Tone, you know, I speak to him, like, yo, what's up, dude? Blah, 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 blah. Where you from? Blah, blah, blah. We about to roll to the club. Wanna go? He said, cool. So me, Joe, Tone, and another dude, I forget his name, it's like, this is like 20, 21 years ago. So we get to the club. It's free for us, because we freshmen. So the people in the club trying to, you know, that's part of trying to reel you in to come to the school. So we get in there. It's white people everywhere. And the funniest thing is to see white people dance when they drunk. The funniest thing to me. So I'm in there just bugging out. And there's white girls everywhere. Blonde, brunette, red hair, purple, blue, pink. You name it, it was in there. So Joe see a couple of his buddies that was on the side of his hall. And they sitting at a table. And so they wave Joe over. We go over there to the table. And all the guys get up from the booth. They get up from the booth. Let us sit down. They're like, y'all drinking? And we like, yeah. So then two of them go. And they bring him back cups of beer. And it is steady bringing us cups of beer throughout the whole night. So now we ain't told up. So before my college career even started, I learned how to gain a tolerance. Fast forward to the first weekend I get to school. With my parents riding up the road to the dorm, I see Tone, with a white dude. So I said, hold on, pull over. That's my dude Tone I met over the summer. So I get out the van. I'm like, Tone, Tone. Run down the way. I'm talking to him. He tell me what room he in and whatnot. So as I get back in the van, we unload all my stuff. You know, I hug my mom and dad, bye, like, y'all see y'all later, blah, 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 I call y'all. Later on, I go to Tone room. Well, Tone tell me him and his roommate, when they was walking down the street, went past this fraternity house, the Deltas. They said they got invited to a party. So I'm like, cool, I roll with y'all. And if anybody seen Animal House, you know, the frat that John Belushi and them was in was called the Deltas. When they got to that house, it was just like the movie. Them dudes just like the Deltas in the movie. In fact, they had this dude named Barney. He was pretty much the John Belushi of the frat. I mean, these guys had a nice little two-story house. They had a big-size pool table in there. So, of course, I get in there. I start playing a little pool with the dudes. And this is 1992. Now, in this time, you know, Pearl Jam was big. You know, the movie Singles came out about 91. That soundtrack was big with Soundgarden and Alice in Chains and all of them on it. The crazy thing is, that's when MTV used to play music videos. So I knew all these songs. So of course, I'm like the cool black guy in the room. Just like another teen movie and stuff. But they always got that one black guy that all the white people love. That was me. So all the dudes love me. All the girls love me. I'm beating everybody in a pool. And then they got a keg, we drinking and whatnot. Then one of the guys was an alum. He was down for the weekend. He was like, yo, born around here, let's roll out to the club. So we jump in cars, like four or five cars deep. We weren't one of the frat guys. He and this big old Buick. It's four of us in the front. There's five people in the back. We get to downtown Greenville. I'm sitting at the window seat. I'm hollering at chicks, because you can tell who freshman, who ain't. So I'm hollering at chicks. They go, oh, who's that dude with all the white people? We get to the club. We're like maybe 20, 30 deep. The alum dude walks up to the bouncer. He said, I got everybody from here all the way to there. And they start putting out money. And so the guy just start waving us in. This the same club we went to in orientation. Get in the club. It's packed, of course. We underage. We can't drink. We don't get no band or nothing. You think that stop us from drinking? Not at all. Because the fellas was just bringing us drinks left and right. We just walking around with beers, keeping it moving, keeping it moving. I sitting there flirting and talking to all types of girls. Fast forward to a time after I pretty much flunked out of ECU, but then moved back to the town about 3 years later. Working at a job. One of my co-workers, white dude named Scott, love rap music. I was like one of his best friends, boy. He loved to come to work when I was working. He said, man, I had this house party. You got to come through. I said, man, I don't know if I'm going to come through and all that. He said, nah, dude, you got to come through. And I told everybody you coming. You know, everybody know about you. My cool ass boss. You got to come through. I said, all right. I get to this house. This party. Me, Tone, and my man, Little Mac. Pull up to the house. People are everywhere. It's like a little 3-bedroom house, 2 bathrooms. People are everywhere. Cars all out in the front. People standing all on the front. Start making my way into the house. And my man sees me. He's like, that's my dog. That's my dog. He starts screaming across the house. Then he starts pushing people out of the way, trying to get to me. I get to my dog. That's my dog right there. Hugs me. Throws a beer in my hand. And proceeds to introduce me to everybody in that house. Now, if you ever seen the movie Project X and you see all those people in the house like that, that's how this party was. On number rap music playing. I mean, it was black people up in there. But we, of course, we was outnumbered. But I met everybody up in that piece. Go to the backyard packed full of people. They got like 3 or 4 kegs. They got a little nitrogen tank. You know, they sucking on balloons and stuff. All this type of crazy stuff. I couldn't believe it. And right then I knew, well, shout out, doubt. White people party hard. So as you can see, I may not have learned anything as far as education goes in college, but I did learn a few other things. I learned how to play pool, which I still know how to play good to this day. I learned how to hustle, which I still do right now. You know, I still hustle and grind. I learned how to holler at white girls, which kind of helped me get my wife. And I learned how to drink and have a hard drink intolerance. As you can see, most of the time I play Call of Duty, I be on that juice juice. But that's all I got for you. Just want to give you a little story, a little back past history, a little background, give you a laugh for the day. It's your big homie, SlickJC, you know, Toys B.I.G., Brother and Gaming. I hit 34 million on that piece. Almost broke the top score. And I'm up out of here like a boss.
I was working at this job, and young lady came in to apply. Oh, she was cute, short, blonde hair, blue eyes. She had a little size to her. As you know, if you follow me on Twitter still, you know, I ain't got no problem with that. You know what I'm saying? Female is a female. You know what I'm saying? As long as she look good with it, you know, carry herself with confidence, she can get it.